We are American extensions of our African history, just like those scattered elsewhere are those regional extensions of their African history. We must remember, quote, when a people and a nation's history are disrupted, their cultural practices illegalized, their physical integrity is forcibly scattered and terrorized, those people do not cease to exist. The history continues to exist as it is beyond the capacity of one human or one human group to destroy the historical and cultural reality of another. And I'll say this again, the African deities tell us what is given by the Creator cannot be taken by man. While my position, we are Africans with Americanism, poses to wake stolen Africans up, his American argument can and will put the masses to sleep. If he is correct, the African masses can say, yeah, I got some African shit in me, but I'm American because this is all I know. Come to think of it, we've been identifying with America since the start of around the 1900s. Us identifying with America has created the conditions talk shows like this were created to combat. American with Africanisms is wrong. It doesn't further the race. It doesn't give us vision. It keeps what we are doing now going. Until the conscious identification with America stops, our decadent and deplorable conditions will continue. We have been lied to that we are not Africans. So what was the purpose of our Americanisms, and how did they start? Do a quick history here. In 1491, you've got the first recorded African to give up their unique way of venerating the universe, and I say recorded, and adopting a foreign way of life. This was the Congo king Nzongo Nkuu. He was converted and baptized in May of that year and changed his name to Dom Jao I. Nzinga Zemba, his son, was taken by Portuguese waves, and he converted in 1506, and his Christian name became Dom Afonso. The unwritten Caucasoid context of this experiment was to see if they could, quote-unquote, civilize the king by exposing him to the, quote-unquote, civilized reality of Caucasoid. The experiment was to get us to not identify with Africa or our African ways. It was to get us to identify with someone and something else. This experiment exceeded Caucasoid expectations. These people had their African consciousness transformed through changing of their names. They had their spirituality changed. The consciousness of their spirituality changed because they was given Christianity. They opened up Angola, that part of Angola, to Christianity. They had their consciousness transformed away from their African customs and value systems by popularizing Caucasoid customs and values within their society. And this opened them up to eventual enslavement and the erosion of their ways. Now, since this was the first run, they didn't explicitly try to get them to personally identify as Portuguese. But through centuries of refinement, as we've heard tonight, it is now us who voluntarily identify with whatever foreign land we are on over our innate origins. And the consequences of buying into this so-called common sense, we're in America now, so we're Americans logic, actually continues. The Portuguese then, full Caucasoid now, anti-African civilizing legacy. This medieval experiment was informally renamed the house slave syndrome, which was the continued creation of transforming African people's consciousness and quote-unquote rewarding them. This house slave system was informally renamed the middle class, the refined continuation of transforming African people's consciousness, rewarding them for it, and then having them serve as the buffer group to shield Caucasoid. The lesson of all of this, the crackers learned then that still operating to this nanosecond, is always create and quote-unquote reward stolen Africans who do not identify with Africa or their Africanness. However, within each time period I just mentioned, there has always been Africans who consciously and deliberately kept their Amun-Ra given Africanness prominent in their lives. In 1520, you had the Angola of Ndongo. They tried to come and convert him to Christianity. He said, I don't want nothing to do with your religion or your way of life. I just want your material goods. The house slave syndrome was countered by the more successful Maroon communities. And the middle class syndrome is being countered today by self-avowed African-centered living communities. It's always been about countering what has been done, not succumbing to it and passing it off as common sense logic. We can no longer accept the lie that we are not Africans. The idea of us being Americans with Africanism plays into the hands of white folks by letting them beat their chests and gives them the idea they can actually make Africans disappear just by relocating them, changing their language, and transforming their consciousness. The idea of us being American with Africanisms means our 200,000-year cultural incubator can just totally be wiped out by the last 500 years blip in time. It cannot happen. It has not happened. What has been given by the Creator cannot be taken by any man. The idea of us being American with Africanisms helps the Caucasoid agenda by cutting us off from identifying with Africa and Africans, even though, like I already said, if you drop any of us off on the continent, we don't open our mouths, they will immediately just see us as African. We need to build on that and not chop it down. The idea of us being Americans with Africanism buys into Euro-American propaganda. They make it seem like common sense, and again, anything that seems like common sense in this environment, we need to check that shit quick and go the other way. Euro-Americans benefit from this identity lie that we're Americans from the collective $1 trillion that benefit their businesses. Euro-Americans benefit from this identity lie that we're Americans from all the time we spend at their jobs working for them and their bottom lines. Euro-Americans benefit from this grand identity lie that we're Americans from all the resources we put into their damn reality. All that money, time, and resources could be better used on ourselves first when we properly identify ourselves as Africans, deliberately become reaware of that reality, and use that to build our sovereign nation. They benefit on us focusing on this small little 500-year blip of time because, and not looking at in the proper context of at least 200,000 years we've been on this planet in Homo sapiens sapien form. So I ask, are we following the Booker T mistake when we should have followed the Garvey model today in 2010? We laid our buckets down then in America. What do we now have for it? American with Africanisms? Really? Really? We've never stopped being African. We've been lied to and haven't been given or not taken the time to get back in touch with who we really are. I'm going to keep saying this. We were originally created as Africans by the African creative forces of the universe. Spirit has been totally devoid out of my opponent's argument. Only recently, check this, only recently have we been told we are Americans. Ironically enough, by the same people who stole us in the first place. So the question becomes, who has more weight for you in your life, dear listener? Ra, Yame, our African gods, or white people who create census forms? This American identity thing is only a man-made law on their books. If two Africans have a child in China, that child is not Chinese. That child is an African child born in China. If two Africans have a child in Russia, that child is not Russian. It's an African child born in Russia. And we all know the Baba Omowale quote, if a cat has babies in an oven, did the cat have biscuits? No, the cat had kittens that were born in an oven. And one of my favorite African proverbs, if a log stays in a river for 10 years, it will not become a crocodile. I'll even add that to say if a log stays in a river 500 years, it won't become a crocodile. It's just a very damp, wet piece of wood. I'm going to say it again. My idea opponent says we're Americans with Africanism. However, most of the people he cites in his books and recommends to other folks never said that. He's an independent researcher. But Dr. Clark never said it. Amos Wilson never said we're Americans with Africanism. Jope never said it. Dr. Nobles never said it. However, there is a small list of people who do call us Americans. Cornel West, Jesse Lee Peterson, Armstrong Williams, Edward Richburg, Shelby Steele, Henry Louis Gates. All within the sound of my voice, I ask you, which identity camp do you want to align yourself with? those whose writings and life's works were explicitly dedicated to the sovereignty of African people, or those who constantly tell us we're Americans, Africa has no large expression in our lives, get over it. If you agree with that last group, that we're Americans, because that's all we know, unfortunately you have fallen prey to Caucasoid propaganda, but all hope is not lost. The work of those first groups are in abundance. It's time to relearn, reacquaint, and re-embrace our African history.